For the last 2 years prior to 2021, we were below 3 million acres, and 2019 was the lowest acreage we'd ever been in since the 1960s. And so because of the flooding issues and the frequent rainfalls we had, low commodity prices there in 2019 and 2020, we were below that 3 million mark. And so this year I was anticipating us being back over that with the commodity prices the way they were, better than we've seen in the last few years. There was a lot of talk for soybeans. And so I was expecting us to be over 3 million. You know, it's always a gamble or a, you know, just a guess on how far over 3 million. I was guessing somewhere in that 3.1 million acres, and that's kind of where USDA has this peg. We did have quite a bit planted early, especially down in the south part of the state. You know, guys down there really pushed the early planting window, tried to maximize yield. But I consider this year kind of a series of starts and stops. You know, the big issue now is trying to finish up this crop before we get a frost. You know, we're supposed to have the first, you know, potentially 100 degree temperatures in the last 3 years this weekend. And people are saying, oh, why are you talking about a frost? Well, if you look from July 1 to November 1, you got 120 days. And if you look at variety testing and kind of do averages of different maturity groups, a mid four is going to take about 115 days to mature, you know, from the time you planted late. You know, it is a little bit, you know, narrowed up, but still you're going to need, you know, 100 plus days to finish that from planting to finishing up that crop. So, you know, if we have a mild fall, I'm not too worried about it. But if we have an early frost, there's a lot of acreage that could potentially be damaged, you know, if we can't get that crop out. And I think that yesterday we're back up running that $14 range per bushel. So, you know, I think that's given us a glimmer of hope. You know, even though we've had some diversity and we may not have the high yields that we've seen the last couple of years, at least we've got, you know, we're not down $7 beans, you know, and only cutting 35 bushels. You know, we got $14 beans, and if we cut 35, at least we're making a little bit more money in that scenario. But this year, you know, it's been a struggle. There's been some shortages of some of the pesticides, and so there's been some complaints on that. You know, fuel prices is still elevated, but you know, farmers are resilient. You know, some of them been through some worse times than we're seeing in 2021 and made it through. But just in the last few weeks, I think the attitudes have gotten a little bit better. You know, pretty blue there the 1st of June. You know, if you went down to Southeast Arkansas, there was some long faces, you know, because of all the work that just got washed away in a matter of, you know, 2 days. But I've talked to several of those farmers down there. They feel pretty good about their crop. I've been down there looking at some of the crops, and they look good, even though they're late.